So I had told you chemical reaction means it is a simple representation of chemical changes that takes place around us in different situations using different conditions. It is only symbolic representation means here we used only symbols or formulas to indicate the chemical changes that takes place around us. So here around us every day, so different types of chemical changes takes place. So according to that, the chemical reactions are also considered as different types of chemical reactions. So among them, the first type of chemical reaction is known as combination reaction. First type of chemical reaction is called combination reaction. Combination reaction, combination indicates combine. That means to join together. So combination reaction indicates when the reactants join together or combine together to give a product, that is called combination reactions. But in the combination reactions, more than two reactants react together or combine together to give only one single product. Here in the combination reactions, we get only a single product. For example, in a general way, if I write X plus Y, then I will get XY. So here X and Y are the reactants and I will get the single, only a single product, that is XY. No more products will be formed. So in this type of reaction, that is combination reactions, only one single product will be formed. For example, if I will take the example, I can write Mg plus O2, that is MgO. You can mention here, but every time mentioning is not compulsory, so you can choose it either as optional also, or if you mention, if you want to mention, then also you can mention. So this is also a combination reaction, because here two reactants combine together to give a only a single product. Here also two reactants combine to give a single product. Another example we can take, like calcium oxide CaO plus H2O, then it will give slagged lime, that is CaOH whole 2, and with that a lot of heat is released here. So here we can mention the state as solid, liquid and aqueous, but in this combination reactions a lot of heat is released along with the product. So here this is also combination reactions, because two reactants combine together to give only a single product is formed. So this is also called combination reaction. In some combinations reactions a lot of heat is released. The reactions, so these are the combination reactions. The reactions, in a simple way you can tell that the reaction in which two or more substances react together to give only one product, that is. So let's take few more examples of combination reactions, that is N2 nitrogen plus hydrogen H2, we will get ammonia NH3 along with the release of heat. Here also a lot of heat is released. Similarly, if we will take hydrogen plus oxygen, we will get water. Here also heat is released. So we are seeing that in all these reactions, along with the product, some amount of heat is also released. So now you, here you can consider that when in a reaction heat is released, that reaction is called exothermic reaction. That reaction is called exothermic reaction. So exothermic reaction means the release of heat. Release of heat. When in a chemical reaction heat is released, those reactions are called exothermic reactions. So now in these reactions, these are combination reactions, because only a single product is formed, but along with the product heat is formed, which is a form of energy. We all know that heat is a form of energy. So here along with the products, some amount of energy, that is heat, is formed. That is why these all the reactions are called exothermic reactions. For some more example of exothermic reactions I can give you, that is methane gas CH4 plus O2, we will get carbon dioxide plus water plus some amount of heat. Again here C6H12O6 plus O2 that is CO2 plus H2O plus energy. We all know very well this is our respiration process. When we take glucose and it is burned in the presence of oxygen, we get carbon dioxide, water and some amount of energy. And I had told you heat is also a form of energy. So here a lot of energy is released. That means it is also an exothermic reaction. So our respiration is also an exothermic reaction. This is also an exothermic reaction because the heat is released. So now the difference between these reactions and these reactions is that this is combination reaction and exothermic reaction. This is only exothermic reaction, but it is not a combination reaction. These are exothermic reactions because of the release of heat. But here in all these reactions, two or more reactants react to give only a single product along with the release of heat. So these are known as both combination and exothermic reactions. But here only one single product is not formed. Here more than one products are there along with the release of heat. So these are exothermic reactions, but these are not combination reaction. So this is the small basic difference between combination and exothermic. Combination reaction means when the two reactants react to give one single product, and exothermic means the reaction in which some amount of heat is released along with the product. So now it is clear for you what is exothermic reactions and the combination reactions. In exothermic reactions, heat is released. In combination reaction, only a single product is formed. But in exothermic reaction, heat can be released with a single product or more than one product. So this is our exothermic reaction.